Hello again. I was hoping I'd be moved out by the time I did another one of these podcasts, but good news is I have something to talk about. It's only been about a day, so I haven't got a chance to really do some house hunting yet. Well, in any case, I have a new toy. My work needs to be able to get a hold of me, so I got a cell phone. Now, I don't know how much people have heard about Japanese cell phones, but I know I heard the rumors that Japanese cell phones are really cool and a whole lot better than their American counterparts. Well, I have to say that they are correct, because the Japanese look at cell phones a lot differently than we do, right down to the way their cell phone companies offer service. There's actually a lot of kind of reversals going on. Now in America, with cell phone companies, you have your peak time and your off-peak time. Peak time would be your 7 o'clock in the morning until 9 p.m. at night, and during that time you get a certain amount of minutes, and if you go over your minutes, you get charged a fortune. I know firsthand. I actually went over my minutes the month before I left for Japan. In any case, then you have your night and weekend minutes, which are usually unlimited or virtually unlimited, and then you have your unlimited mobile-to-mobile minutes. Well, with SoftBank, which is the cell phone company that I use here in Japan, they work it pretty much in reverse. You have to pay for time after, I think it's 7 p.m., but during the day, you actually have unlimited free calling to other SoftBank users and some other perks. It's a little bit less expensive to call non-SoftBank users, and they actually don't do set minute plans. They do either prepaid, like we have in the States, or they have really, really cheap plans. Basically, their normal plan, if you're planning on using your cell phone a lot, is about $10 a month, and you pay by the minute. So, if you're calling other SoftBank users during the day, it's free. If you're calling non-SoftBank users during the day or calling at night, it's something like 20 yen per minute, which it works out to about 20 cents. And that's actually pretty cheap. And then if you pay $20 a month, you actually get your the minutes that you have to pay for go down to 10 and a half yen per minute, or 10 cents per minute. So it's actually really, really cheap, all things considered. And part of that, I think, the reason why they don't give you a whole mess of minutes is usage of cell phones in public is actually kind of considered rude. There are actually signs on the bus when I was going from the Narita to the Haneda airports in Tokyo. It's about an hour and a half trip, and it actually says, "Please turn off your cell phones as they may disturb your neighbor," or "bother your neighbor." I don't know what the exact Japanese translation said, but probably something to the similar effect. So basically, using a cell phone to call somebody on a train or a bus or a plane, well, obviously a plane, and even kind of walking down the street and such, is considered a taboo. It's not done. And I believe I talked about how you can't use cell phones, period, while driving, whether you have a hands-free device or not. So most people, I mean, you don't use your cell phones that much, so they're pretty much emergency devices, and they're treated as such. Well, going to the other side of the house, there's also text messaging. Text messaging, on the other hand, is pretty much considered okay, because you're not sitting there talking to somebody. So people text message all the time. Now I got the prepaid setup, and they actually have a text messaging program for it where you pay, your $30 to get a phone card, and that lasts for 2 months. But during that time, you can pay 300 yen or $3 to get unlimited text messaging for 1 month. Now, text messaging works a little different in Japan than it does in the States. There's your SMS messages, which is cell phone to cell phone. That's pretty much straightforward. That's the same as in the States, only it's only within a certain company. You can't just do a SMS text message to another cell phone on a different cell phone company. Now, the way they get around that is you get an email address. Mine, I have an email address through SoftBank, which is just for my cell phone, where anyone who has another cell phone or anyone who has access to email can send me a message, and I can send them a message. And it works out really, really nicely. I mean, you can only send 300 kilobytes worth of information before they charge you, but think about it. Anyone can get a hold of you from anywhere for $3 a month. There's really nothing like that in the States. So I'm only going to have to pay maybe $15 each month. It's $30 for 2 months, and I can pretty much get a hold of anyone and be gotten a hold by anyone. And the other thing that's really interesting is, and this is not true in the States either, is when somebody calls you, you don't get charged whatsoever. And that includes my prepaid service. My prepaid service stays active for up to a year before they just completely cancel my phone number and turn off my connection. And up to that 1 year point, I can still receive calls for as long as I need to. That's pretty cool too, especially seeing as how this cell phone is basically so that people can get a hold of me. And of course, having a couple minutes, so say I get into a car accident or something off base, which from what I hear happens fairly frequently because of the snow and ice, I can call the police and get help if I need to. But other than that, I mean, I can really communicate a lot for very little money, something you really don't see in the States. On top of that, if you look at the cell phone one more time, you see that little black dot right at the top there? That's actually another camera. Now, you've got your normal digital camera on the back, but then you've got this little camera on the front. And the crazy thing is that is for video phone calls. Evidently, video phone calls are pretty much commonplace in Japan. Another thing you just don't see in the States. So you can actually call somebody and video call them. Now, I'm sure that you really need to have a service plan to make it cost effective. It's something like 16 yen per 6 seconds for me to do it, which is actually a lot. If you think about it, that's 16 cents per 6 seconds. That translates to a lot of money if you make more than a 2 second phone call. But for the people that actually have plans and can do that between cell phones, I mean, I can really see that being a lot of a really big hit with especially teenagers and such. So yeah, American cell phone companies, learn something. I want to see these in the States in the not too distant future. Anyway, that's it for now. I will be sending out my cell phone email address through my photo mailing, but not on here. And